Hello! We have a guided reading lesson for today. First, I'm going to go over three sight words. First word is where. W-H-E-R-E. Where are you? Where. The next word is went. W-E-N-T. Went. For a walk. Pretend like your fingers are legs and you're walking. Went. Walking. And last word for today is again, A-G-A-I-N. You know whenever you're playing on your swing set and you want someone to push you again and again and again, okay? So he is swinging and someone is pushing him again. All right, so I have a story for you today. It's called Catching Santa. Can you see the title page? All right, first we're going to do a picture walk. So that's where we just look through the pictures. We don't read any of the words yet, okay? So let's look at the picture. I see lots of different characters. Here, let's look at those two pictures. Be asking yourself, what do you think is happening here? Oh, he has a flashlight. What's going to happen next? What does he see with his flashlight? And where is he now? Okay, I see some stockings in that picture. All the characters back together. And last picture, he looks excited. I wonder why. I wonder what happened, okay? So that's kind of how we get a little preview of our story, what is going to happen. All right, one of our reading strategies I want to go over before we start reading, chunky monkey. Okay, this is when you look for smaller words or chunks that you know inside of the word. Okay, there's a little song that goes along with this. Okay, so put your arms up like you're climbing a tree, like a monkey would. You go, chunky, chunky monkey, look for words you know. Okay, so that is going to help you when you're reading this by yourself. Chunky, chunky monkey. Okay, and the title of our story is Catching Santa, okay? So you can follow along as I read. And if you want to try to read it by yourself, you can turn your volume down, okay? On Christmas Eve, the Hoppers hung their stockings by the fire. They planned to stay awake until Santa Claus came. What can we do to pass the time? Asked Fluffy Tail. One of us could tell a fairy tale, said Floppy Ears. Why don't we make some popcorn, said Speedy Legs. The Hoppers munched popcorn and waited for Santa Claus. 10 o'clock came. Oh, that's late. Then 11 o'clock. The Hoppers were wide awake except for Mother Hopper, who fell asleep in her chair. Then Speedy Legs said, I hear something. It sounds like sleigh bells, said Floppy Ears. Is it Santa? Cried Fluffy Tail. The sleigh bells came closer and closer. Soon they heard footsteps coming toward the door. Snubby Nose ran to the door and opened it. It is Papa, cried Snubby Nose. Sure enough, Papa Hopper was home late from getting the Hoppers their presents. He had sleigh bells on his hat and boots. Merry Christmas, Hoppers, said Papa Hopper. He hugged all the Hoppers and sat in a chair next to Mother Hopper. Snubby Nose hopped up on his lap. Did you see Santa Claus? He asked. Santa Claus, said Papa Hopper, sitting up. You Hoppers know that Santa won't come unless you're asleep. That's right, said Mama Hopper. Off to bed, all of you. The Hoppers groaned, but they went to bed. Mother and Papa Hopper tucked them in and turned off the lights. It was very late, and soon all the Hoppers fell asleep, all except for Snubby Nose. I want to see Santa Claus, thought Snubby Nose. I will creep downstairs with my flashlight. Snubby Nose took his flashlight and snuck downstairs. Soon he heard sleigh bells coming closer. He heard the pitter-patter of reindeer feet on the roof. Then he heard Santa Claus coming down the chimney. He waited until he saw the fur on Santa's boots. Then Snubby Nose turned on his flashlight and cried, Ha! I see you. Santa Claus jumped straight into the air. He was so surprised. Oh, what are you doing up, Snubby Nose? You know you're supposed to be asleep. Snubby Nose was very startled. He dropped his flashlight and jumped into the closet under the stairs. I'm sorry I was bad, Snubby Nose said to himself. I hope Santa doesn't put coal in my stocking. Snubby Nose could hear Santa filling the stockings. Then he heard him going up the chimney, and he heard the patter of reindeer hoofs. Finally, he heard sleigh bells ringing into the distance. Snubby Nose was upset, but it was very late, and soon he fell asleep. The next morning, Speedy Legs, Floppy Ears, and Fluffy Tail ran downstairs. Their stockings were full of treats. Mother and Papa Hopper came down after them. Where is Snubby Nose? Asked Papa Hopper. No one could find him. But then Fluffy saw a note taped to Snubby Nose's stocking. It read, I met Snubby Nose last night, and we both had quite a fright. Snubby Nose had such a scare, he ran and hid beneath the stair. Speedy Legs opened the closet door, and out jumped Snubby Nose. Santa Claus filled my stocking with coal, didn't he? Cried Snubby Nose. I don't think so, said Mother Hopper. Snubby Nose ran to his stocking and found it full of treats, just like the other hoppers. Then Snubby Nose found another note at the bottom of his stocking. It read, Santa Claus is very shy, but he will never pass you by. Snubby Nose laughed and jumped up and down. I will never try to catch Santa again, he said. Then all the hoppers had a Merry Christmas. And that is the end. There are 6 questions I have for you. After I read it, please pause the video and answer the questions about the story, okay? So the first question, why do you think Santa won't come unless you're asleep? Next is, what would you do if you met Santa Claus in your house on Christmas Eve? What would you do? Would you be scared just like Snubby Nose and go hide? What would you do? Santa Claus doesn't leave presents for naughty children. Is this a statement or a fact? Okay, and how do you know? Remember, a fact is something that can be proven true. An opinion is your own thoughts. Why did Snubby Nose think he would find coal in his stocking? Why did he think that? What did Snubby Nose learn about Santa Claus that day? What did he learn about Snubby Nose, or about Santa Claus? And last question, how can Santa Claus visit every house in just one night? Okay, how can he visit all of those houses? All right, make sure you answer all of those questions. I have a sight word I'm going to teach you, okay? The word is because. Because, B-E-C-A-U-S-E, because, that is a big word. How many letters are in the word because? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, say the word with me, because. Right, I'm going to erase some letters and you are going to have to try to tell me what they are. I'll be easy on you at the first part, okay? So, what letter is missing? It's at the very beginning, because. There it is, B-E-C-A-U-S-E. Okay, I'm going to take out another letter and see if you can tell me what it is. B-E, missing letter, A-U-S-E. What letter is missing? It's a C. Good job. Because. B-E-C-A-U-S-E. All right, let me try another one. Okay, our last letter is missing. What is it? B-E-C-A-U-S-E. All right, I'm going to try to trick you this time. This will be our last time doing this one. Oh, let me draw my lines. I took away two letters this time. Can you figure it out? What two letters are missing? B-E-C-S-E. Two vowels, A and U. So say that word with me, B-E-C-A-U-S-E, because. Great job. All right, speaking of vowels, do you know what vowels are? There are five vowels in our alphabet. A, E, I, O, U. Say those with me. A, E, I, O, U. Good job. Okay, so when two vowels are together in a word, the first one does the talking. Okay, so when these vowels go walking together, the first one does the talking. And it always says its name. It doesn't say its sound, okay? The other one just covers its mouth and doesn't say a word. It won't talk, okay? So for E-A, those are two vowels together. You can see the E is talking and saying its name. So E, and then our A is quiet. We have double E, E-E, says its name, E. A-I, A says its name, and I is silent. Same over here, O-A, O. When you see O-A, the sound is O. U-E, U says its name, U. And E is quiet. Same with U-I, okay? Another secret story that I want to talk about really quick is our O-W and O-U. Look at, what are they doing in that picture? When these tough guys get together, they play really rough. And someone always gets hurt. They cry, ow. And that's the sound they usually make. But if O-W ever spots superhero O flying up overhead, they will stop dead in their tracks as he's their idol. That means he looks up to them. Or they look up to him. And they shout his name, O. Okay? O, and that's the other sound that they can make. So they can say ow or O. And same with down here, O-U, ow. They're hitting each other and it hurts. Okay? So I'm going to make a T chart. And we're going to work with some sounds. I have O-W. And I have O-A. Okay, so with those secret stories, you know what sound that makes. I just told you. O-W, what do they say when they're beside each other? Ow. And O-A, those are when two vowels go walking. The first one does the talking. So when you see O-A together, it's O. Okay, so whenever I say a word, you're going to listen to see if I say the sound ow or O. All right, are you ready? So the first word is cow. Get your tapper out and we're going to tap out the sound. So we have k, ow. Do you hear ow or o? O-W, cow. K. What letter should I write first for cow? C, C-O-W. All right, the next word is coat. The jacket that you wear, coat. Tap out the sounds, ready? K, O, T, coat. Again, K, O, T, coat. Do you hear the ow sound or O? The O, K. I'm gonna start my word with C. I have O, A. What's the last sound you hear in K, O, T, 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 T? Job. All right, next word, now. Ow. What sound do you hear? Ow. What do I start with? N. What letter makes the N sound? N. Ow. N. N-O-W. Good job. All right, next word is float. If you're floating in the pool, float. F-L-O-T. Float. F-L-O-T. Float. You hear ow or o? O. What sound do you hear first? This is a blend. Fool. Ooh. Blend those sounds together. L O, and then what is going to end with? T T T. Two consonants here together, a blend. F L Oat. Float. All right, next word is soak. You're soaking in the bathtub. Soak. S O K. Soak. Do you hear ow or O? Oh, good job. S. It's the first sound. S. O. K. K. The end. K. S O A K. Soak. Job. All right, another word we have is down. Tap that sound out. D. Ow. N. Down. Do you hear ow or O? Ow. What sound is it? What letter is it going to start with? D. 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 Ow. O-W. N. D. Ow. N. What letter makes the N sound? N. Great job. All right. One more word, probably for each side. We have the word crowd. Cr. Ow. D. Crowd. Which letter? Which sound? O or ow or O? Cr, ow, d. Cr, C R O W, d, d. Cr, ow, d. And last word for our chart is toad. Like a frog, a toad. T O D. Do you hear ow or O? I hear O in the middle of that. T. What letter is first? T. O. D. D. What letter makes the D sound? The D sound. D. Toad. All right. Great job. Thank you for watching.